press star now. Please enter your PIN followed by the pound or hash. Thank you. You are the only participant in the conference. All participants are muted. To start conference record, the recording has started.
Good morning. Happy Monday. Welcome to the Reignited Prayer Call. Good morning. It is Motivational Monday, Miracle Monday. Good morning.
The way may not be clear. God knows, and yes, He has a plan.
Probably because it was too close and too loud. Amen. Well, we're going to go ahead and we're going to get started. We are going to get started. Thank you guys for coming on. I know it is a holiday. Today is President's Day, and a lot of people probably sleeping in. So we're going to get started. The word must go forth in season and out of season. So we're going to just be prayerful that everybody gets on and catches the replay later on today. Today is Motivational Monday, Miracle Monday, all those good M's for Monday. And I just thank and praise God for you that are on the call on this morning. Dear most gracious Father God, we just thank you, oh God. We thank you for waking us up another day, oh God. A day that we can praise you, oh God. A day that we can just love on you and bask in your presence, oh God. Lord, I ask right now in the name of Jesus that you decrease me and increase you, oh God. Give a word to the women on the call this morning, oh God. Let your word minister to their hearts, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen. So I have a word on this morning that God gave me. And he actually gave it to me last week. First Sister Nina, Minister Nina, hit on it last Thursday. And last Thursday, she said that her message title was, I Knocked on Heaven's Door. I Knocked on Heaven's Door. And so she came from Luke 11 and 9 through 10. It says, ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door will be open to you. And then later on it says, to the one who knocks, the door will be opened. And so He said in the scripture in Luke, it said, but before you ask, seek, and knock, you have to let the Holy Spirit dwell inside of you, right? And so listen. Revelations 3 and 20, and that's where we're going to be coming from today. Revelations 3 and 20, and it says, good morning, Mitzi. And it says, listen. I stand at the door and knock. If any hear my voice and open the door, I will come into their house and eat with them, and they will eat with me. And so this morning, I want to ask you a question. Who is knocking at your door? Who is knocking at your door? My God. And so we're going to break down that scripture today, because that scripture just, it really ministered to my heart last Thursday, and I've just been thinking about it for the rest of the week and on the weekend, and so God just said, yeah, this is it right here. And so who and what are you listening to this morning? See, the scripture started off with the word listen. And you know, when we listen to something, we have to be actively listening, right? You know, there's a difference between listening and hearing. And so when we're listening, we have to be actively listening and opening up our ears to something. And so he says, listen. He says, I stand at the door and knock. I stand at the door. See, God wants to come into your heart, but what is he coming into, right? So we know that a door gives us access to something, right? When I open the door, I now have access to what's on the other side of the door. And a lot of times we like to say that, you know, God is opening up doors. God is closing doors. So he's either opening up access or he's closing access to something. My God. And so if he's standing at the door and he's knocking, that means he wants access to inside. He wants access to what's going on the other side of the door. My God. And so what will he find once he knocks on that door and he gains access to that door? See, David said to create in me a clean heart. So if God is knocking on the heart of your door, have you created, asked God to create that clean heart within you? My God, my God. And so good morning, Shalonda. And so it's like, you know, sometimes you go to somebody's house and first off, I'm gonna tell y'all right now, I'm not the house visiting type. I'm not. I got so many friends, so many loved ones, so many people in my core, but I'm just not the house visiting type, right? And so I don't go to everybody's house, and you shouldn't go to everybody's house. Mama told you don't go to everybody's house, right? And so you just can't go and stand at the door to everybody's house. My God. But see, I want Christ to come and stand and knock at my door to my house. And so then he says, I stand at the door and I knock. Well, what is knock? What is knock? And so I looked up the word knock, and it says a sudden short sound caused by a blow, especially on a door, to attract attention or gain entry. See, when somebody knocks on something, they knock. And normally the knock is a loud knock. It's not a quiet knock, because if it was a quiet knock, you wouldn't be able to hear somebody at the door, right? And so it's normally a loud knock. And see, that knocking means that it needs to attract attention. I need to get the attention of what's on the other side of the door. So God is standing at the door and he's knocking. He's knocking at the door because he needs to get the attention. He needs to get your attention. He needs to see what's going on the inside, my God, of the house. And so, you know, there's certain knocks. Have you ever noticed that there's certain knocks? Like when my kids come and knock on my bedroom door, I can tell which child it is, right? I can tell which kid is knocking on my door. All I got to say is, come on in, BJ, you know, because I know his knock. Do you know God's knock today? See, that I know I've been experienced where the police has come and knocked on the door, and they don't just knock, knock, knock. They bang, bang, bang on the door, right? And so have you ever heard somebody say, dang, you knocking like the police, right? And so, but they're getting somebody's attention. They need to attract the attention of what's going on the other side of the door. And see, that's what God is saying on this morning. He's knocking at the door. He's knocking on the door of your heart. But are you allowing him to gain the attention that he needs, okay? And so even on Friday, on last Friday, Pastor Amy, she came with a powerful word, and she talked about the crowd, the community, and the core. And so you don't want the crowd just coming to your house, knocking on your door, right? You barely even want the community coming to your house, knocking at the door. So who's standing at your door on this morning, knocking, wanting to gain access? And so the second part of the verse says, if any hear my voice, Well, first of all, he started off with the word if. See, sometimes God is standing there, but we don't want to let him in. We might even hear him knocking. We're going to hear him knocking, right? Because it's loud and he's trying to gain our attention. But just because we hear him knocking doesn't mean we let him in. My God, doesn't mean we open the door. See, you have to be careful of the doors that you walk through, and you have to be careful of the of whose doors that you walk through, right? See, everybody just can't walk through your door. Everybody just can't come into your house because you don't know what they're bringing inside of your house. You don't know what spirits are attached to them that they might deposit or drop off at your house, right? When you go to somebody's house, have you ever been to somebody's house and you walk through the door and you just kind of felt something, like something don't feel right in this house? You know, some houses just don't feel peaceful. They just don't feel welcoming, right? Sometimes you go in a house and it's cluttered. There's a lot of mess. There's a lot of stuff, right? And you just feel all instantly just, you know, you just feel like, ooh, you know, you just can't walk into everybody's house. But see, God is standing at your door. He can come into anybody's house and he can clean it up. He can clean up your heart from whatever's in your heart that isn't supposed to be there. Just like David said, created me a clean heart, God. But see, God can walk through that door. He can walk through any door that he wants to walk through, and he can clean it up. He is knocking at your door this morning. See, the Bible says in John 10, 27 and 28, he says, my sheep hear my voice. They hear my voice. And so he says, if any hear my voice, but if we are his sheep, we're hearing his voice and we know him and we follow him. And he says that he's going to give us eternal life, that we will never perish. No one will snatch them out of his hand. So we have to hear the voice of God. We have to hear his voice so that way we can open the door. If we don't hear his voice, we can't open the door, right? So you just can't hear his voice, but you have to let him in by opening the doors of your heart. But see, sometimes we don't want to let God in because we so messed up. We think we so jacked up and so messed up that we don't want to let God come into our hearts. We don't want him to clean out the stuff because maybe we okay with the stuff that's going on in the inside. Maybe we're okay with the depression. Maybe we're okay with the infidelity. Maybe we're okay with the lying, the cheating, and the stealing. So we don't want to let God in. He's knocking on our door, but we don't want to let him in because we know if he comes in, he's going to want to clean out what's on the inside of our hearts. My God. And so, number three, the end of the verse says, I will come into their house. And we're not going to be on here long this morning because I'm not going to tell y'all no story. I'm going to get back into bed this morning. And so he says, I will come into their house and eat with them, and they will eat with me. I will come into their house and eat with them, and they will eat with me. So first off, y'all know I can't eat at everybody's house. Y'all know it's just some folk, you can't go to their house and you just can't eat. You know, mama said you got to be careful who food you eat. When you have those potlucks at work and, you know, everybody's bringing in food from the potluck. And I'm picky. So if your food not wrapped up from the store, then I'm not going to eat your food unless I know you personally. And I know how clean you are. And I know that your house clean. I know that you don't have dogs and cats walking all over the counters and different stuff like that. Don't get me wrong. If that's your thing, that's your thing. Go right on ahead. But see, everybody you just can't eat at everybody's house. You can't just sit at everybody's table, right? But he says, I will come into their house and I will eat with them and they will eat with me because they heard my voice. And so could Jesus come to your house right now at this moment and eat with you? What is your house looking like right now? Can he come and sit at your table and dine with you? What do you have going on at your house? See, is Oscar at your house that you're not married to laying up at your house? Joe Blow at your house that you're laying up with that you know he's not supposed to be there? Can Christ walk into that right there? Do you have people living at your house that you know ain't right and now your kids are seeing this bad influence at your house? Can God knock on your door and come in and see all of that and eat at your table? My God, what's going on at your house? Are you doing things you know you don't have no business doing and you know you need to clean your house? Well, God is saying, I'm knocking at your door. I'm knocking at your door. Listen, I'm knocking at your door. All you have to do is hear me and open the door and he's going to come in and eat with you and they will eat with, and you will eat with him. 1 Corinthians 3:16-17 says, don't you know that yourselves are God's temple and that God's spirit dwells in your midst? His spirit dwells in your midst. You are God's temple. What are you letting him in on today? What are you letting him in on today? It says, if anyone destroys God's temple, God will destroy that person. For God's temple is sacred and you together are that temple. And that's out of the word. That's out of God's word. It says you together are that temple. You don't want him to destroy your temple, but you want him to come in and sup with you. You want him to come in and eat with you. You want him to come into a temple that's clean. God, I haven't gotten rid of all my flaws, God, but I'm trying, Lord God. I want you to come in and I want you to clean my heart because I want to be able to sit and dine with you. I want to be able to sit and sup with you, to eat with you, my God. God wants to come in. He's knocking at your door, but are you going to allow him to come in? Are you going to allow him to come in this morning? And that's what he's saying. See, sometimes we need to go and we need to reevaluate what's inside of our house, what's on the other side of the door. We need to reevaluate what's going on inside of our house. Is there so much clutter in our house that we need to clean it out some? We need to make room. I think it's Jonathan McReynolds singing that song, Make Room. We need to make room for God to come in. And not just make room, but we need to get rid of that stuff that's on the inside. You can't keep clutter around forever. You got to get rid of all of that stuff. So what is God is knocking today, but what door is he knocking on for you? Is he knocking on it and are you going to open the door to allow him to come in? See, the door is ready to be open. Pastor Amy got those doors up because she did a whole series last month on doors and the access to doors and the types of doors and how doors can open. But see, God can open doors and he can close doors. But this morning, we're talking about your door, your personal door to your temple that he's knocking on, that he wants to gain access to. He's knocking hard. He's knocking clear. And you need to listen and hear him. Because he wants to come in and have access to you. So don't stop it. Don't stop it. Don't say no. Let him come on in. Let him come on in. Ask him, God, create in me a clean heart and renew a right spirit in me. My God. Well, I just want to thank you guys for getting on this morning. I know it was probably a little short and sweet. But thank you for waking up still at 5:30 a.m. this morning. I hope the word bless you on today. We're going to go ahead and we're going to pray. Dear most gracious Father God, Lord God, I thank you for knocking at my door, God. I thank you for coming in and sitting with me and eating with me, Lord God, so that I can eat with you, oh God. Because if I'm able to have you come in, Lord God, I have access to you, not just now, oh God, but eternally, Lord God. And that's what I want, God. I want to be able to sit with you forever, reign with you forever, Lord God. So come into my heart, God. Come into the heart of these women on the call, Lord God. Come into the heart of the women that's even going to be on the replay on today, Lord God, and just sit with them, oh God. Dwell with them, oh God. Creating them a clean heart on today, oh God. Allow them to open up the door so that you can have access to their temple, oh God. Not just access, oh God, but that you can go in and that you can remove some things, oh God. That you can move some things around, oh God. But that you can sit and you can dwell with them, oh God. So that we can be in your presence and sit at your table, Lord God, and eat with you, God. Lord, we just thank you, God. We praise you, oh God, on today, oh God. Those that are getting rest, oh God, let them get rest in you, Lord God. Let them get rest in you today. Let them be able to just even sit at your presence, in your presence today. There's some of us don't have to go to work today, oh God. So let us do something a little bit more with you on today, oh God. Lord, we thank you, God. We praise you, God. We thank you for the assignments that you're giving us, oh God. We thank you for not just the assignments, oh God, but being able to walk in our assignments on today, oh God. I don't know why I'm praying about assignments, oh God, but today, oh God, give us those that don't know their assignment, God, I ask right now that you release to them, even right now, their assignments, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God. Lord, we just love you, we praise you, and we thank you in Jesus' name, amen and amen. Thank you, ladies, for getting on this morning. I know, again, it's a holiday this morning, but you still chose to wake up and get on the Reignited Prayer Call, and I thank you for that. I love you guys. We will be back on the call tomorrow morning at 5:30 with Minister Tammy or the Reignited Prayer Call. God bless.